In this video, we will learn how to install the current SQL version on Windows 11. Let us start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type SQL Server and press Enter. The official website is visible, that is Microsoft.com. Click on it. So we have directly reached the downloads page. We will mention this link in the video description as well. After reaching here, directly click the downloads menu. Now Microsoft SQL Server versions are visible. Go below. Here you can see SQL Server 2025 is visible. We will go for the free edition, that is the Express edition. So just click the download now button. The download started, let's wait. So we have downloaded the installer file for SQL Server. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started. You need to select an installation type. I'll go for the basic installation. Click on it. Now the license is visible. Click accept. Here the SQL Server installation location is visible. It will get installed in program files and it will only take 727 MB. Not a problem. Click install. Now Express edition will download, then install. Let's wait. Installation completed successfully. Here the connection string is visible. This is used to connect SQL with programming languages like Python, Java and others. This is the log folder. The following is the installation media folder. And here is the installation resources folder. Now you just need to click connect now. If the following is visible, that means we successfully installed SQL Server. But we need to work on SQL. For that we will install SSMS, which is SQL Server Management Studio. This will ease our work on SQL. Click install SSMS. Now it will redirect us to the official website of Microsoft. Okay, so we don't need to worry. Here it is. Go below. Here is the latest version. Click here. Download SQL Server Management Studio. We downloaded the installer file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. So here it's written, click continue. Now it will get the Visual Studio ready for SQL only. Okay, so you don't need to worry, just wait. So here our workloads are visible for SQL Server Management Studio. Here I'll select all the four components: AI assistance, business intelligence, hybrid and migration, and last code tools. It will take 3.5 GB. So you just need to click install, because install while downloading is by default selected. Click install. Now it will start download and then it will install. Let's wait. We have installed it. It's written done installing. Click OK. Now we can directly click launch here, or we can go to start and type SQL Server Management Studio. Here it is. It's the same. We can click open here, or we can directly click launch. I'll click launch. Minimize this. Minimize this as well. Now click skip and add accounts later. Now SQL Server opened for the first time. Here we need to add the server name. So for the server name, go to start, type about. After typing about, click here open under about your PC. Now you can see your device name is Amit. Okay, so minimize. Enter your device name here, Amit, and after that type slash SQL Express. Okay, after that under encrypt, select optional, and that's it. Also here you can see under username it's written Amit, so we added it perfectly. Now let us click connect and our SQL connected. Guys, SQL Server opened for the first time. Now here databases are visible. I'll click on it. These are the default databases under system databases. So to create a new database, I can either right click here and click new database, or I can go to new query and click here. Now I can type a command. Okay, create database is the command to create a new database. So let's say my database name is Amit. Okay, so this is how you can create a database. In place of Amit, you can add any name like student, company, or any other name to your database. To run it, click here and click execute. Now you can see commands completed successfully. So if this is visible, that means we successfully created a database. Now you would be wondering why it is not visible here, because for that you need to click refresh. Now it's visible, Amit database. Now to create a table, you can right click here and click new, then table. For a free SQL tutorial, do refer to the link in the description of the video. I have shown how to create a database, create multiple tables, connect them, and perform different operations.